people ask me, why in the world would you want to run for Congress? And I tell them, it's because I want to build the biggest bridge ever. And that's connecting reality to Washington, D.C. But that's really the disconnect. And, you know, especially now with the Washington wanting to, you know, tell us how to raise our kids, and with Common Core trying to force upon every one of us the what we're going to teach to our kids, and then track them with asking them all kinds of questions that the government doesn't have any business knowing, somebody's got to put a stop to it. Well, I don't know that in the history of our country we've ever had a bigger disconnect between our government in Washington, D.C., and we the people here in Iowa. But what better way to bridge that gap than to send a bridge builder to Congress? Well, I don't have time to tell you much about our business, but we have a bridge contractor, an engineer, and we built a lot of structures around here, like the Blue Arch Bridges on 235, or the White Arch Pedestrian Bridge down by Wells Fargo, and structures all over the state. But what I want to tell you a little bit about is my family. And I grew up outside of West Des Moines. My folks, I had the privilege of having parents who taught us, and I was the youngest of six kids, taught us a faith in God, and also how to serve others. They put their Christian faith into works and by serving others. My wife, Lori, when we were engaged at age, ripe old age of 18, she had the opportunity to live with my parents for a year before we got married. And it really changed her. It's for the first time she was able to see a mom and a dad together and see how that Christian walk is, how the talk is walked out. Well, that carried over to the way we raised our kids, and they're now young adults. And it even opened the doors. We started to decide to open our door to foster kids. So I remember about 4 years ago, we got a call from DHS, and they said, hey, we've got, the police found five little kids from the age of 7 to 13 months wandering in the snow looking for their mom, who was next door, carted. And they said, can we bring them over? We didn't know any better. He said, sure, yeah, bring them over. So this is our first placement with foster care. And it was chaos. It was really chaos. But it was so great to see the change in these kids from simple things like providing their health needs and watching this young girl, six-year-old girl, her hair start to grow out healthy for the first time. See the seven-year-old boy who didn't own a toothbrush, all of a sudden now starting to brush his teeth all the time because they're starting to have healthy teeth. But it was so much better when we started to teach them and work. They were going to public school, but we were working with them, teaching the young boy phonics for the first time and getting him glasses so he could actually see the book and the chalkboard and to see his self-esteem rise as he started to learn and started to have that self-confidence of, hey, I can succeed if really given a chance and given the attention that is, unfortunately his parents weren't giving him. So I want to take that model of servant leadership that I saw growing up and saw throughout my life and take that to Washington. So many times we have to choose between the business guy who has the resources or the conservative who will fight for life, fight for family, fight for our values, fight for freedom of education. And I say, and is better. So I appreciate you getting with me. I really appreciate your vote. You can check us out at this table back here and on our website, and I'd be honored to talk to you. Thank you so much.